The word hacker was first used at MIT in 1960. During that time, a group of computer science students were working on artificial intelligence. Most likely, these talented young individuals would hack at a problem until they had a solution. The term hacker was not associated with any malice. However, as time has passed, when someone refers to a hacker, it often has a negative connotation. And many think of a hacker as someone who is trying to break into a system to steal information or release malware. Now, there's an entire subculture of hacking groups. All have different attitudes and goals. Many times, someone will group all hackers under the term hacker, but there is a difference. The three main types of hackers are the black hat, the gray hat, and the white hat hacker. Black hat hackers are considered to be the bad guys. A black hat may also be referred to as a cracker, as they may try to crack the code or crack a password. A black hat has an objective to cause harm by engaging in criminal activity. Many times, they're backed by organized crime or even a nation state. The black hat operates on the dark side of the internet, damaging organizations, spreading unsavory content, and threatening governments with cyber terrorism, and can cripple a victim's financial well-being. White hat hackers are considered to be the good guys, as they are ethical hackers. The white hat hacker has the support of government and industry and are computer experts. Many times they are contract employees hired by security companies and are trained to test systems and attempt to break into them, but they can also be an internal team conducting regular penetration testing as part of an overall security plan. Ethical hackers diligently look for any system vulnerabilities in the computer's defense system, which once identified is reported so they can mitigate the vulnerabilities, either by the white hat hacker team or the appropriate IT personnel, with the idea of improving the company's defense posture. A gray hat hacker sits between the good guys and the bad guys, in that they may try to gain access to a system without permission, but in general, without malice. It's many times they want to see if they can access the system. A gray hat hacker will many times notify an organization in some manner that their system was vulnerable. Black hat hackers have a large arsenal of software tools, malware, and social engineering techniques used to breach a system. Anyone, either internally or externally, with proper motivation and the right situation, has the potential to become a hacker. And that's the idea of the white hat or ethical hacking comes into play. Ethical hacking enables an organization to fine-tune their security posture, educate their staff, and implement security practices that protect critical systems and sensitive data. Ethical hacking requires advanced security knowledge of security weaknesses, vulnerabilities, and remediation options. An ethical hacker's job is to identify vulnerabilities. Ethical hacking can be done either in-house by a trained IT professional or outsourced. As outsourcing may be expensive, a company may choose to do an ethical hacking assessment in-house. If done in-house, select an appropriate candidate. Although someone might self-identify as a potential white hat hacker, take care in making your selection. Recommendations include selecting someone who understands the skills required. Ethical hackers uncover vulnerable entry points before attackers have a chance to exploit them. They have patience and persistence. Not only do ethical hackers need to find the vulnerabilities, they must suggest and/or implement methods to reduce the threat. And ongoing training is essential. they respect the code of good conduct. The term ethical implies that the candidate understands what is right and what is wrong. The candidate understands checking and reporting are to happen only to team members and management, and not to a group of friends at a bar after hours, which would possibly compromise the security of the organization. And the candidate is a professional team member, in that the ethical hacker is proficient in communicating any discoveries and will work with all team members to ensure a comprehensive approach that supports the overall security plan. Ethical hacking continues to evolve and is gaining attention as an essential security practice that every organization should perform on a regular basis.